Well, it looks like we're finally here.
Where?
The climax, of course. The big showdown where everything that's been boiling over in the novel so far comes to a head, and the protagonist has to figure out what he's going to do in order to succeed in his objectives.
I see. Well, I don't see what you gotta say about it. Your hero has to fight the villain, or get the girl, or both, depending on your novel. It really doesn't matter. You just have a climax, and then the book's done.
Well, not quite.
Not quite what?
Well, it's not quite the end, which we'll be talking more about in the next video, but it's also not easy to write. Because while it may seem rather straightforward to write an ending, it's also pretty easy to do it poorly.
How would you do a climax poorly?
Well, okay, there are a lot of ways that you could do a climax poorly, okay? So you could kind of, you could make the climax kind of underwhelming, or you could make it too over the top and ridiculous. You could make it so that the heroes win without having any real struggle, or make it that they win via Deus Machina.
Wait, Deus Machina?
Yeah.
What's that? Do I look like I know Latin?
Well, no, but okay. So, for you, and for the other viewers, the phrase literally means God in the machine. It's a common trope in ancient Greek plays of solving the problem just by having the gods show up and solve them. Today, it means that you basically save the protagonist by having some kind of contrived plot device save the heroes when nothing else could. Like a random earthquake swallowing up an enemy army, or the lover randomly finding his girlfriend in the middle of the street when he really needs to talk to her. Basically, it's when the hero wins by luck alone, and that doesn't work very well for a climax.
Okay, so I think I see what you're saying and how you can mess up a climax, but how do you make sure that you avoid all those things? I mean, how do you really know whether the climax will be underwhelming or not?
Well, here's the way that I like to think about it. When you're writing a story, if you're writing successfully, then you should be setting up a lot of expectations for the reader. These expectations can be many things, like creating expectations that the hero will slay a dragon, or that the boy will get the girl. Or that the detective will find the killer. Essentially, what you're doing is you're creating expectations for the reader about what will end up happening. The more obstacles you place in the hero's steps, the more the readers expect him to have to do really great things in order to conquer them.
Okay, but what does that have to do with how underwhelming a climax is or isn't?
Well, basically, whether or not a climax is overwhelming or over the top or too easy or too contrived has to do with the expectations that you've given the reader. In order to write a good climax, you need to meet all of the reader's expectations. And generally, you don't just need to meet them, you need to go above them. So if you're promising some epic battle between good and evil at the end of the book, the reader will be disappointed if the hero just wins by doing a quick assassination attempt on the villain at the last minute. If you write a lot about how difficult the villain is to beat, but then the hero beats him without any trouble, the reader will know that you've been lying, and they won't like the climax.
Kylo Ren?
Be quiet! So in order to write a successful climax, you need to meet and rise above expectations.
Beating the expectations of the reader seems pretty hard.
Exactly! And that's why a well-done climax can be hard to pull off.
I see. So the climax needs to beat the reader's expectations. Does it need to do anything else?
Well, honestly, there's a lot more that could be said to do about how to do a climax well, but...
Yeah, you're right. Nobody wants to hear about what you have to say for a climax or a whole, like, half hour. That'd be torture.
Fair. Okay, that being said, though, if anyone is interested in reading more about this, I wrote an article for Kingdom Pen about how to do a climax a couple months ago. So there's a link in the description if you're interested.
Seriously? You're seriously just gonna link to your article in this video?
Look, I'm trying to help our viewers, okay?
Sure. Sure you are, yeah. Are we done now?
If I said that I wanted to close out this episode in a good way, would that be an acceptable answer?
No, we're gonna cut to the credits. I've just noticed that my hair, like, changes every single time. So.
Yeah, we haven't had the viewers start talking about it yet. Maybe we should make it.
Into a meme. Daniel's different hair.
Yeah, you should.
Straight up ones like Jeremy Lin.
Actually, I'm kind of tempted to do that and post on our Facebook.
You should.
Mind that?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Use your totes.
Okay. Is that dark?
Totes.
No, don't use that word.
All right. Yeah, we're. Okay.